Hey everybody, welcome back to The Witcher with Roach, myself, and Vesemir. Before we get started here, I think it'd be wise to invest some of our points. And I say some because I don't think that we should invest all of them right now. We don't have another slot that's unlocking till level 4, which we might hit dealing with the Griffin, I'm not sure. So I'd like to reserve some points for that. But it doesn't make sense to invest in a lot of other things right now because we only have the one thing that's equipped. Sure, we could invest and then switch out for Sun and Stars and maybe just have Sun and Stars as something we switch in like after fights or whatever. That's something that we could consider. But what I'd like to do is just get these going since this is like pretty much a primary. I have to actually put it in the slot, I understand. Since this is such a primary attack that we're using all of the time, it makes sense that we should kind of invest and improve these abilities. So let's do that. I think I'm gonna go 2 levels, which takes us up to 15% adrenaline point gain at 3%. So that's pretty good. I'm gonna hold on to the other 2 for when this unlocks, and then I'm thinking probably start to go into some of our signs. Specifically, this delusion seems very interesting to me because of the effectiveness during dialogue. That could really help us out down the road, I think. But all of these are actually quite good. Quen's really good, Irden's really good, the Igni sign's really good, weakening armor, Ard's really good. Like, I would like to spend a lot of my time in this tree, but there's so many good abilities that it's going to be tough to figure out exactly what we want to do. Okay, let's put the sword away, shall we?
A stream, amber waves of grain, charming place, perfect for an ambush.
I know how to choose them. So, ready?
Yes, I believe that I am ready.
Let's start. Wind's good. Bait's scent will spread quickly.
Now all we have to do is wait. Come on. We can cower in the shade of those birches.
So tell me, once we find Yennefer, what'll you do? Got your eye on a contract?
No. I'll go to Kaer Morhen.
Little early to settle in for the winter.
Snows are a way off, yes. And that's what worries me. Nilfgaard's crossed the Pontar in the east. Puts them maybe a week's march from Kaer Morhen. If they reach the valley before snows can cover the passes, well, we need to cover our tracks, hide our paths. Speaking of winter and wintering, think you'll come this year?
I think that depends.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Might bring a guest.
Yeah. We gotta find her. Look
it's
at this
close.
Thing.
Let's go give it a warm welcome. Wait. Take this. A crossbow.
Won it in a card game while you ran around. Might come in handy.
So that's what you've been working on. Took you for a bit of a traditionalist, sticking with swords and such, but I guess we adapt.
A witcher with a crossbow? We breaking with tradition?
Stop talking. Got a griffin to kill.
All right, let's get serious.
Watch out!
Okay, so we've got... Oh, there it is. We have a crossbow. That's awesome. Let it bolt loose.
It's about to die!
Whoa! Are you serious? Got our Thunderbolt that we can use as well. 30 seconds? That's gonna hurt. Oh, we gotta reload this thing too. Figure we gotta use that Thunderbolt while we can. Let's go. That is wild. There we go. Damn it. No. Oh. This guy is strong.
Damn. It's fast.
There, we got a lot out of our Thunderbolt that time.
Don't let it get away!
You serious? I don't think so. Here we go! We can see some of his, like, blood that is dripping. Yeah, here we go. When using your Witcher senses, you not only see more, but hear more. Hold it to heighten your senses and determine the origin of distant noises. Okay. You can also just follow its path of blood everywhere. Oh! I wanted to make sure our sword was out.
Weaken soon!
My god. Oh, that was bad. Gotta remember that these things take some time to reload. Holy hell. One more. There it goes. Woohoo, that is wild. Okay.
Not bad. Not bad. Though you could stand to improve some
things.
Yeah,
I agree. What do you recommend there, Vez?
For example, upward vertical strike. It's too obvious. But more on that later. Take the Griffin's head to the Black Ones. I'll ready our horses. Meet me at the inn.
Wow. Okay. We're gonna take its head. So we've got some mutagens. That's interesting. Feathers, infused dust, and a trophy. Okay, you found a mutagen, use it to enhance your abilities or create a special potion called a mutagen decoction. Okay. Place mutagens in the appropriate slots to gain a bonus to your character's stats. Select the mutagens tab. Choose a mutagen, place it in the indicated slot. Plus 50 vitality. Okay. Once activated, mutagens grant bonuses to your character stats. Both mutagens and abilities are marked with a color. Put a mutagen in field with at least one ability of the same color to increase its bonus. Nice. If an ability does not match the color of the mutagen in its field, it does not increase the mutagen's bonus. The increase gained from any other abilities in the same field, which do not match the mutagen, remains. The more abilities in the field that match the mutagen, the field's mutagen, the greater the mutagen's bonus. Each matching ability increases the bonus by 100%. Mutagens can also be used to brew powerful potions called mutagen decoctions. Okay. So we don't have any invested in green currently. We're getting vitality plus 50, which is great. But if we had greens in here, looks like it increases pretty significantly. So that's something that we're going to want to be paying attention to. Oh, look. Wow. Okay, so is that the trophy? Yeah, Griffin trophy. 10% chance to dismember. Yeah, I like that. We also have the Noonwraith trophy. The experience. I think the experience actually is the way to go right now because it's so early. You see the most benefits. But now we have a choice. So we could go back and just give our hand in the trophy. But I think what makes sense is go out and tackle these things. And then that's all of the points of interest that we have, except for that one area down here, liberating, yeah, monster bandit attacks. So, we could do this, wait till night, go and clear this one out, and then go and hand in the trophy, and I think that that would be the best thing to do, honestly. Oh, look at the trophy, that's so cool.
Whoa there, Roach.
Why are you freaking out, Roach? It's all right. Griffin probably spooked you a little bit. Understandable.
Whoa!
Hidden treasure? Who's guarding it? Wargs. He's gonna be freaked. Yep. Oh, here we go. Definitely gonna need to meditate soon. This is dangerous. Really dangerous. There we go. Whew. Scrawled note. Oh, this could lead somewhere. Another formula, some crowns. And of course a rake, because why not? Okay, look at this. We've got a saddle. So, horse equipped with a saddle won't tire as easily. This is the same as what we already have. Looks like these are what we would upgrade. Or we get separate saddle bags to increase the amount that we can carry. Things are going better and better for us. We've pitched camp in the heart of the forest near the old mill and have already done quite nice for ourselves. Folk are poor, so they say, but squeeze them and something always pops out. Sack of grain here, a few crowns here. Not bad for easy work, certainly better than the army. At least we've got something to fill our bellies, and the risk that we'll pay this all with our lives, well, still less than when we were charging the Nilfs at Natalis' orders. Interesting. Dirty funds. Yeah, if we can track them, why not? Find the treasure. We're a ways off. Gonna have to meditate soon to get a new batch of potions going. I guess it's still technically daytime, so we're regenning a bit, but...
Don't let him catch his breath!
Oh yeah.
Fuck!
It's those archers that really cause the most trouble. We're not done.
We'll flail your skin off.
Don't let him catch ball!
Whoa, that is wild.
Damn it.
Even that doesn't... We're gonna have to get behind him. It's like, holy shit. That's crazy. Hunting gauntlets. All right. Hunting boots. Vials. I like those ones where it kind of leads a soaked letter. Where it kind of leads to something else, you know? Scrawled notes. Okay, we read that one. Here's a soaked letter. To His Excellency Velarad, Lord Mayor of Vizima. Your Excellency, I can't even say it, Your Excellency. We can wait no longer. The scouts say the Black Ones are already readying their siege equipment. If you wish to escape with your life, please present yourself at the Vizima Temple Quarter sewer entrance tomorrow at the crack of dawn. There is not much room on the boat, so take what you can, or so take with you only your closest family and most valued treasures. I shall provide a few men to act as a guard, but not too many, for I do not wish to attract unwanted attention. We shall sail through Black Soul, Stunwar, White Orchard, and Clark's. From there we shall continue on horseback. Yannick Dellan, do not tell anyone about your flight. We do not wish to arouse panic. That's interesting. I wonder if something about that's gonna come up later. Hey, Fistech! That's awesome. I've been looking for a new Fistech, something to collect and never get rid of. Where is it though? Vial. There it is. Yes, I'm super happy that that's back. Not that I'm addicted to it or anything, but you know. This camp's a total disaster.
Go, go.
It's okay. I'll take you down. Hopefully it's just the one. That would be amazing. No, it definitely isn't. Come on.
What now, you piece of filth?
We're actually hitting, like, really hard. Spy's notes, yes. This is what I'm talking about.
Strange.
Is this the spy? Must be. Guess we're gonna find out if we check the notes. Fifteenth day of observation, 23rd of Burke. Back in the camp, brought in heaps of plunder, mostly armor and weapons, but this time a sealed chest too. Towards dusk, a man delivered rations of food and drink. Messenger arrived in the camp before dawn, caused quite a stir. They immediately organized a group to transport the chest. After dusk, I'll try to track down where they carried it to. Didn't move the case that far away, just to the abandoned hut near the old mill. Set up a watch, I wasn't able to get closer. Every man in the camp had been drinking since yesterday afternoon. If we attacked now, we'd obliterate them. Too bad the commander only sent one man, me, to this outpost. I'll try to sneak in tonight. If fortune smiles on me, perhaps one man will be enough. By the windmill. Didn't we already... like, we've been to this windmill. This is it here, right? I think we've been out there. But we'll keep our eyes peeled. Doesn't look like it worked out very well for him. Okay, what else is out there for us? Nice. Yeah, we should. Oh, are you kidding me? You are kidding me. Strong, very strong. There we go. What is that? It? That's awesome. Where did she go, though? I don't think we killed it. What do we have here? Oh, look at all the-
Strange.
What? Holy hell, what have we done? Guarded treasure? Back. Whoa! And just like that, she is no more. Novigrad longsword and a Matina blade. Now, we have a really great steel weapon. I can't see these being better. Yeah, they're not. But still cool. And they're worth a little bit, right? So these are probably good ones to sell. We could dismantle, but... oh, nice, too. We have the Igni Sign Intensity. I wonder if I should just go ahead and use that. It fits into one of these slots, no? I guess not. It can go in here, but it can't go on there. Maybe it has to go on, yeah, piece of equipment. So it would probably say, like, weaponry. Let's do it. Why not? We're gonna find plenty of those, I think, so... I did not expect that. So, we run to this place of power, cool. Wraith takes off. Oh, all of a sudden, secret treasure underneath. Like...
Medallion's humming. Place of power, it's gotta be.
May as well refresh it. That's really cool. There we go. Oh, a nest. Oh, we don't have a bomb.
Medallion's humming. Place of power, it's gotta be.
There we go. Is that all of them?
Ghoul nest. Ought to just destroy it.
So we'll have to come back when we get a bomb.
Ghoul nest.
Are there more?
Ought to just destroy.
Yeah, there are. Damn it. You're not gonna make it, I don't think. Oh, he did. Thought we'd just let him burn. No such luck.
Ghoul nest. Ought to just destroy it.
So, we'll have to make another bomb and come back. Looks like we have one more out there.
Slow now. Whoa.
Now, what is it exactly? Is this just out in the middle there? Ah! Oh, are you serious? We got something going on out here. Oh my god, okay. If it's red or marked with a skull, it means the enemy's much stronger. Better to turn back. Will they attack me when I'm here? Oh my god! That answer is resounding yes. Okay, well, that's kind of interesting. How in the hell? And it's deep, too. What if we come at this during the daytime? Would that be possible? Did we not do it? There we go. replenish our items. Now, drowners, I imagine, since they're nighttime, they should probably be gone. No, they're not. Okay. Oh, get away from me. I'm gonna try and get whatever this is and get out. Well, we did it. Not sure that it was worth the risk and all losing all of our sign bus, to be honest, but some trousers, Matina blade. You know, we might as well use this glyph. Can we put it on weapons? No. We can put it on armor. Okay, so good news is we only have a couple of things left that we could really take care of. We have this, which I'm thinking is
come on.
I'm thinking it's something to do with things only coming out at a certain time. And we went there during the day, so we're gonna have to go back at night. But I would like to do that.
That's it, Roach.
Come on. But for that, we are gonna fast travel there.
Place of power. Should draw from it.
I should actually redraw from this one again. And I'm just gonna use this to get to, let's see. Let's go and see our herbalist here so we can buy ingredients to make the bomb. I always get confused of where she is from this location. So behind us, okay.
Yes?
Got any herbs you're willing to sell?
I'm sure I can find.
Okay, can we get some of this from you? Oh, we're so broke. It's crazy. What could we sell her? What's this stuff worth? Not a lot. Honeycomb's worth quite a bit. And what else could I sell her? What about some of our junk? Gold ruby ring? It says it's a magic item. Let's sell one of them. Because it's worth quite a bit.
Farewell.
And now, what we could do is try going down towards this abandoned village. Okay, so now that we're here, I like that the fast traveling doesn't actually impact our signs, like our buffs. Let's go ahead and create that bomb so that we can get rid of the nest in the other area. I guess it's alchemy, right? So we already have this item, however, I already have it. So what does that mean then? How do I recreate these bombs? How do I get more of them? Oh, we have them here. This must replenish when we meditate as well. That's interesting. Is that how it works?
Faster. Come on, Roach.
Look, whose place is this, I wonder? Whoa, okay. Somebody who just couldn't handle it anymore. That's too bad. Let's get rid of some of the stuff we don't need just to bring us under. What are the cheapest ones?
Move it.
Oh, look here, now there's certainly stuff. What are these things exactly? Just ghouls.
Damn, you're ugly.
Let's clear one first. There we go. Come on. There, cleared. Welcome to your new, I guess you call this settlement. These are probably my favorite ones to do, just because it feels like actually rewarding. You feel like you've given these people like a purpose, you know? Oh, and it's an herbalist too, that's cool.
What? Got anything interesting?
So he sells all sorts of stuff. I would like to be buying all of these different manuscripts and decoctions that we run into. It's just that I can't afford it right now.
Farewell.
Okay, and now what we're gonna do is go and close that nest to the north, I believe it is. Yep, this one. But what we'll do is we'll fast travel there from this village.
Come on.
Okay, we're here. We had a little bit of a crash. First one, actually. And, yeah. We're back. So let's go clear out this nest. And then we're in a position to collect our reward, which is hopefully a shitload of crowns. Because we are one broke witcher.
Mandalion's humming. Place of power. It's gotta be.
It is, but I have one thing on my mind right now. And so we learned that the bombs replenish with our meditation as well. That's amazing. So the whole, like, everything works very differently from the way we're used to it. and I'm totally fine with it. And the reason I want to make sure to handle all of these things, as many as possible, is because, you know, our levels are quite important, I would say. So now we've literally cleared out every point of interest in White Orchard, which I think is fantastic. And they were all enjoyable. Like, I love that. That was really good. What I would do is, like, because from the beginning I wasn't really bouncing between them as fluently as I could have. And I'm going to make sure that in our next area, or maybe we'll get more in this area too, who knows, but in our next area for sure, I am going to try and cover off as many of those as we possibly can by just doing it between missions. And we did that for the most part, but last two episodes we spent a lot of time going through and trying to find all this stuff, which is... To me, it's fine, and I hope you guys like it too. I know some people aren't going to be into the side quest, but that's, to me, that's very important to these type of games, and this one specifically, so. Hey, where are these guys? There were a whole bunch of people here before. Oh, here they are, okay. It's like, shit, maybe something bad happened. But, no, not quite. And what we'll do is just take a break right here and come back and we will talk to him about a reward. See you soon. Bye.